So what exactly is front-end development? Well, when we build websites, there's two things going on. First of all, we have a server, which is a computer where our website is hosted. On that server, we have what's called our backend code. In the Drupal world, this includes our PHP code as well as our database. And anything on the server is considered the backend. The front end, on the other hand, is anything that happens inside of the browser. So that would include HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. With Drupal, the two worlds are often mixed. The backend code is responsible for generating the HTML and CSS that gets sent to the browser. In a lot of ways, Drupal and other CMSs and frameworks have allowed us to bridge this gap, this period of time where we didn't have good front-end tools for organizing complicated code in sustainable ways. In the last couple of years, however, the range of front-end tools has broadened dramatically, to the point where we no longer need a backend in order to organize complicated CSS, HTML, and JavaScript. In addition, as I mentioned before, there's been a decoupling of the backend and the frontend, and the form this usually takes are APIs. A backend is used to sort and aggregate data, and then that data is sent to the frontend, and the frontend takes care of displaying that data. This is the reason why many people are focusing on a front-end development skill set. It's highly portable. It doesn't depend on any particular backend. So you can use them with Drupal or any other CMS, as well as any other framework, including frameworks in other languages and other platforms, like Node.js, for example. It's also possible to build a complete application without managing your own backend at all, just using third-party APIs like Facebook or Twitter. This is something that you can't say about the backend. A backend requires a frontend in order to interface with real people. So at its core, front-end development boils down to three components: HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Everything else that you learn about front-end development is intended to help you organize and generate HTML, CSS, and JavaScript files. So we're going to start at the beginning, assuming that you know nothing about HTML, CSS, or JavaScript. We'll begin by looking at what HTML is and how to structure HTML markup. Then we'll layer on how to use CSS in order to style that HTML. Now, the deeper you go into front-end development, the more complicated it seems, because there's additional layers on top of this basic layer that we need to keep aware of. For example, to layer responsive design on top of this basic foundation of HTML in CSS adds a good bit of complexity. And then if we add the additional layers of building our code for accessibility and for optimal performance, it starts to feel a little crazy-making. So while a big part of what we're going to cover in this series has to do with the actual techniques and technologies, my hope is that I can demonstrate the benefits of adding these additional layers and help you manage the complexity in a way so that you don't get overwhelmed. Okay, so let's begin.